following prescribed is transcribed.
Good evening. I'm Jerry G. Bishop, and this is the famed split-level dungeon studio where, many years ago, the legendary Svengoolie burst into television prominence. Even today, many fondly remember Svengoolie providing the same classic entertainment as such time-honored shows as Hello Larry, My Mother the Car, or Celebrity Pin Spotting. But then, one day, at his peak, Svengoolie simply dropped from sight. The rumors were many. That he'd dyed his hair and changed his name to Phil Donahue. That he'd gone on to a rewarding career in motel management. No one knew for sure. And yet, one rumor still is whispered among an uneasy populace. What if there were the same situation as in the past with the son of Frankenstein? The son of Dracula? Sanford and Son? Could there exist somewhere, somehow, the son of Svengoolie?
Hey, Dad, can I borrow the keys to the hearse tonight?
Yeah!
Ah, thank you. Ah, good evening. I am the son of Svengoolie.
Well, I didn't think you were Rula Lenska.
Well, it's an honest mistake. We've got a movie for you tonight that makes Dawn of the Dead look like Godzilla meets the Brady Bunch. Right, guys? Huh?
No.
Well,
sorry.
Well, it's an honest mistake, too. It's called In the Year 2889 and stars Paul Peterson, who used to play the son on the old Don Reed show, huh? Also, it stars such people as Quinn O'Hara, Charla Doherty, and, who else is in this movie?
Rodney Allen Rippey.
And, of course, Rodney Allen Rippey as the asbestos in Tom Snyder's hairdryer. Okay, roll the movie. I'll be back in just a little while. Let's get to the movie now, all right, guys? Thank you. All right, roll the movie. Let's get on with it. That's Roots. Well, that's better. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, after months of grueling research, personal interviews, and fact-finding junkets to exotic places like Sheboygan and Berwyn, I finally traced the Svengoolie family back to its humble, if somewhat sleazy, beginnings. Of course, the first part was simple. There was dear old Dad, in whose footsteps, 10½ triple E width, I follow. And before him was Grandfather Ghoulie, who, interestingly enough, was the indentured servant, and we still have his dentures here to prove it, of the famed Kunta Kinte's American cousin, Clark Kinte.
Ooh.
Yes, mild-mannered reporter for a great metropolitan, but that's another story. Anyway, Grandpa Ghoulie, of course, came originally from Transylvania in Western Europe, where the supernatural aspects of our family are quite evident, since his mother was a medium and his father was an extra large.
Oh.
He was an extra large, it's very... And then our story took an unexpected double reverse when we discovered that our next ancestor, Robert Chicken George, actually came to Europe from California. Spurred on by this, I surpassed even Alex Haley by tracing even further back through the family, generation by generation, further and further back, and finally, triumphantly, I traced the Svengoolie family back to its earliest and lowest form of life, and that was Chuck Barris. Oh. All right, oh, I like that guy. All right, we'll be back with more stuff right away. Roll the movie. Oh, he's a rescue. Yahoo, what a...